Elon Musk is one of the better fits for this Anyone But Care series of mine. From the information age, we can begin to see what living in an age of understanding truly would be like. How many people do you think talk bad about Elon Musk based on what he has done professionally versus who they think he is privately? How many say that despite what he's done in his chosen professions, he's not that good of a person from his public interviews? How many say that regardless of the results of his chosen professions, he's a bad person due to his tweets, his personal thoughts, other things he's chosen to share, or other things about his private life that have become public? Some of these mudslingers will claim that they like things like green energy. Then you have Elon, who created the Tesla company in large part to revolutionize battery technology. Some of these people also claim to be very concerned about overpopulation or the mismanagement of resources, how we're ending the world and things like this, whereas Elon Musk is interested in space exploration and expansion and resource acquisition. With SpaceX, there's also the Skylink program, putting satellites in space, which will give folk access to information and education, and Elon's early work with PayPal also played a part in advancing digital forms of currency. So you'll give people all over the world the information to improve their lives, and then the means to actually purchase and exchange resources in order to actually do something with those things. So a lot of these people are criticizing him. They may look at these things and say, okay, yeah, we agree, those are good things. But Elon is most definitely a bad guy because he's going to vote for Ron DeSantis because the Democrats have been seemingly ineffectual at best. How many millions of people will say this about Elon over his politics, but then wear a Che Guevara shirt? Or see somebody in one of those Che Guevara shirts and think nothing of it? Because Che was one of them. He supported the things that they wanted as well. He was one of the people. But then, what would they think about Che Guevara if he had a Twitter account back when that Marxist revolutionary was engaged in what they may mentally have revised into these mostly peaceful coups? And unlike the January 6th one that some of them are probably watching in rapt attention, or the committee meetings and things like that, the coups that Guevara was involved in involved a bunch of people shooting at other people with guns that were shooting back at them with their own guns, resulting in many people actually losing their lives rather than one woman being shot as she climbed through a window by some of the people who were protecting the actual government. Here's something I found about Che Guevara, something that he wrote in his early 20s after observing the state of parts of South America. "I will be with the people," he wrote in a journal that he called Viaje. I think it's Viaje or Journey. "I will dip my weapons in blood and, crazed with fury, I will cut the throats of my defeated enemies. I can already feel my dilated nostrils savoring the acrid smell of gunpowder and blood, of death to the enemy." So I would prefer to align myself with anything that Elon Musk is saying about free speech and the expansion of consciousness than things Che Guevara said publicly, let alone what Che Guevara thought privately and later went on to do. I'd like to think that with the increase of information can help us get a better understanding of who we are as people and as a society. History has a way of mythologizing human actions, but now we live in a time where we see how humans act around people who are doing things that were once just things once attributed only to myths.